Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I am Akanksha. So let's start off with part 2 of the video. If you haven't watched the part 1, then do watch the part 1 and then watch part 2 so that it makes more sense. So let's go on to part 2. Highlighter is something everybody loves. Literally nobody will have powder, blush, anything, but everybody will have highlighter because they want to glow. But bro, you gotta do steps rightly to get that proper amount of glow. If you glow, you know, here, but you don't have any other dimension anywhere, it's not gonna look good. So bronzer is important. If you're doing makeup, then do get a bronzer. So coming to highlighters, there's again a cream highlight and there's a powder highlight. So usually powder highlights come in this format, like in a pan, and this is a cream highlight. This is like a sample piece of cover effects illuminating drops, which is really nice. So again, if you're going in with a cream product, going before you set your foundation, basically before the powder. So when you're doing, like if you're doing a cream blush, cream contour, then immediately go in with cream highlight and then set your face. And you can use this highlighter post the last step. You can use after you're done with the entire makeup routine, you can use this highlighter, doesn't matter. Why do you need highlighter? Now highlighter is something which basically enhances your features wherever you want to basically glow. So like when you look at me right now, I have like a touch of highlight here and in the inner corner or and on the side, like on my cheekbones. So basically like when light hits, these are the points where, like, you know, grab a lot of attention. So when you're looking at me, these are the three points which you would like basically look at and you'll get a lot of attention. Like maybe if I don't have this, my nose would look you would see all the bronzer and like everything. It's not looking so structured. Maybe looks a little off, but when you look normally, like, you know, if I have a highlighter here, obviously your attention goes there. But highlighter is very tricky. You need to be very like mindful of how you place it. So if you have like textured skin, anything, so it can exaggerate your texture or pores a lot more, because of course the metallic, it's supposed to highlight. So only highlight in the areas where you don't have textures, like in the around the inner corner, is the best place to highlight. It grabs a lot of attention to the eyes, looks really, really beautiful. So coming to the shades of highlighter, if you are like lighter skin tone, then you can go with literally a light pink, a white, a icy white, something which is like champagne, looks really beautiful, really good. But when it comes to medium, don't go with something which is icy, something which is a little pinkier or icy or something like that, because it tends to look gray. So basically if you look straight, like, you know, in that angle and the light hit, it looks really beautiful. But once you like move straight, there'll be like a gray cast of that icy thing, which won't look really pretty. So go with champagnes, little golden, like toned down golden, not like literally golden, because again that would be too deep. Highlighter is something which has to be tad bit lighter to your skin so that, you know, it gets enhanced. You cannot go with like too deeper shades. Now when you have like, if you have of course more deeper skin tone, then you can go with a little more goldeny color or anything like that. So for application, if it's a cream highlight, you can go in with a brush, again a sponge, your wish. If it's a powder highlighter, again just use a normal small brush. Next, let's move on to brows. Now again, in brows there's so many different products, it's really overwhelming. In brows there's various different types. Like I made so much notes, you guys, it's like too much. So for brows, there are different types: pomades, powders, pencils, and liner pens. So pomades are basically pods. I'll insert a picture here, which are usually ideal if you have like really none to like no brows, less or no brows. It's like a really thick, what do you say, a paste type of thing. It is a little difficult to use if you're a beginner, but that is what a pomade is. Then there's powder, so basically like a pressed powder. It's a brow powder. You use a brush and you apply it with that. Next, it's a pencil. Pencil is something I use because I already have thick brows. I don't usually go with pomades or powders because I feel like they make my it's like a little riskier because those tend to make my brows look a lot more thicker than I want. So pencils are really a safe game for me. I really like pencils. I always, most of the time, just use pencils. And then again, these days we have liner pens. So like, you know, normally you have eyeliner, right? So you even have liner pens for brows these days, so that they just help you get like really nice thin strokes. So if you're somebody who doesn't have like, you know, brows, you want to draw on brows, then those things really help to get that very sharp stroke type of thing, which looks really nice, really beautiful. Coming to the shade, I would suggest you to go with a pencil which is a shade lighter than your hair color, like head hair color. So it just that it looks really soft and nice put together on your skin. If you're like a blonde, or you have like, you know, some brown highlights or anything, tend to like, you know, start going a little lighter on the brow pencil as well, because if you use like thick black brow pencil and you have brown hair, it doesn't look nice. It basically just overpowers your entire face and it's not going to look pretty. Now again, there is in brows there are different types. Again, you have brow mascaras as well. So brow mascaras are usually tinted or clear. Tinted ones have color to add that, you know, if you have like really light brows and you want to darken them, then that brown mascara will help, you know, add that color. Or even a brown mascara basically just sets everything in place really well. So if you don't want to add any color, then you can go with a clear brow mascara as well. Next is the eye primer. So basically, I usually just use a concealer to prime my lids, and I make sure I set them really well so that they don't crease. But there's of course eye primers which you can use. So if you're somebody who doesn't like really heavy concealer on the eye, you can definitely go with the eye primer and just add a touch of eyeshadow. I just tend to go in with concealer because my colors pop a lot more when I use a concealer, because it's sticky, it kind of sticks really well, and I make sure I kind of blend it very well so that and there's no creases of the concealer as well. Next is the eyeshadow. Again, in eyeshadows, there's various different types of eyeshadows. So there's matte eyeshadow, there's metallic, there's shimmer, there's glitter. Now, again, there's powder eyeshadow and there is liquid eyeshadow. First, let's talk about powder eyeshadow. You know, this is an eyeshadow palette, right? So this is called a matte eyeshadow. So this is called like a shimmery eyeshadow. And like you could call this like a metallic eyeshadow, and then there is like pure glitter. So glitter ka, I don't have anything around me. I'll put a swatch or like a picture here. So basically glitter, chunky glitter, that is one more type. So in metallics and shimmers, there's again different types. Again, there's like a single tone, like a pure gold shimmer, let's say, or there's sometimes monochromatic or duochromatic, basically like two different colors. So it's like, you know, if you see like this, it looks pink, but if you shift, it looks more yellow or goldeny type of thing. So this is how a proper shimmer eyeshadow should look. It's so pigmented, so beautifully you know, pigmented, not chunky at all. Looks really beautiful, hits the light really beautiful. So that's like a matte shimmery eyeshadow, but this is of course a single tone shadow. But I really like that shade. I have it on my inner corners. It looks really beautiful. Next we have liquid eyeshadow. Now there is liquid mattes as well, but I don't own any of them. But there's again liquid metallics and liquid glitters. Now liquid metallic is something like this. This one is from Swiss Beauty. It's basically just like a metallic shade. Looks pretty much like the powder one, but you know, it's a liquid form. It's more intense and blinding. Whereas there's a glitter one. This is not like a glitter shadow, but this is a glitter liner. So basically this one has like chunky glitter particles in this. So this is like a liquid glitter. It's a silver one. This is from Urban Decay. So again, liquid, different types and different finishes. So when you're looking for an eyeshadow, a good eyeshadow palette, the things you need to keep in mind are pigmentation, and it should blend really well and stay for a really long time. So these are the three factors you need to keep in mind when you're going for an eyeshadow. Now in eyeshadow, there's various different types as well. So basically there's like a normal eyeshadow formula, which has been like a stable thing since a really long time, but recently we have pure pigments. So basically they're literally pure pigments of colors which are added and pressed into a palette so that you get a lot more pigment. Now I would not suggest you to go with pure pigmented palette, because it can get really overwhelming for a beginner to work with, because they're extremely pigmented and you need to blend them out really well, or else they look really not patchy, but really strong if you don't blend them out well. So for a beginner, you can go with something which is like an eyeshadow palette like this one. So this one doesn't have any pressed pigments as far as I know. It's like all beautiful eyeshadow, blends really beautifully, it's super 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 soft, looks really beautiful. If in case you use a pressed pigment, one thing you need to keep in mind, it doesn't happen to all skin types, but it can happen to few people, that your eye does stain. I mean, it doesn't permanently stain, but of course, like if you use basically pinks or reds, your eye does stain of that pink color because it's a pure pigment. Whereas if you use an eyeshadow, that usually doesn't happen. So next, let's move on to liner. So for liner, you have various types. One is like a felt tip liner, and one more is a liquid liner. So felt tip is basically like a pen which has this tip, and you just have to like randomly just stroke and use something really easy for a beginner. I really like using a felt tip liner. So much precision when you apply, really good for somebody who is terrified to try a liner. But next one is a liquid liner, which basically is like comes with a brush, comes in a, like the product comes in a pot, and then this is a liquid liner. Now again, there is types of liners as well, like in the terms of finishes. So there's a pure matte eyeliner as well, but there's a liner which is a little more shinier. So it depends on your choice which one you like. I usually really like a very matte one. I don't know if you can tell a difference in this part, but the NYX one, this one right here is the NYX one. It's kind of very matte, but you can see this one from Eva is like a little shinier liner. It's not completely matte, if that makes sense. If you're a person who uses liners, then you would understand that there's like a little shiny liner and there's a very proper matte type of liner. So the two things I showed you are like, you know, black liners, but they're various different colors. I don't think there's any color these days which you cannot get in a liner. But of course, you know, a lot of people use lipsticks as eyeliners as well, but then only use that if the lipstick says it is eye safe. It will be mentioned on the website if the lipstick is eye safe or not. If the lipstick is eye safe, then you can use like those also like a liner. So basically those things you need to use like a separate liner brush and apply them. So there's various different colors. Now recently we have another type of liner which is basically activated with water. So basically they just look like an eyeshadow in the pan, but once you add water in it and you start, they kind of turn into liquid, and then you can just paint your face on. They look really beautiful, really pigmented. So next one is an eye pencil. Now eye pencil is nothing but like a kajal pencil, you could say, but of course there's various different types of kajal. Now this one this is like from Sugar. So basically this like a kajal pencil, right? So you have various different colors and different tones. I have few colors right here. So this one from Nykaa is their Violet Wizard. So basically it's like a violet color pencil. There's various colors, various types. The only thing you need to look for in such type of eye pencil is that it is smudge proof, because this is the product which is like most difficult to find. Usually pencils do smudge, so even if it's kajal, liner, whatever, make sure they don't smudge at all and give you a really long lasting finish. Next one is mascara. Now mascara is something you use for your lashes to basically, you know, increase and like, you know, make them look really full. I do have false lashes on, but you can see the application of the product. It's a really good mascara. So again, in mascara, there's a lengthening mascara, there's voluminizing mascara. Usually they claim one product claims everything, but I do think you need two products. But if you're a beginner, one is totally fine. This is a good mascara. It lengthens also, it gives volume also. Now there's waterproof, there's non-waterproof mascara. So if you are somebody who wants, like if you are basically, you know, watery eyes, then it's better to go for waterproof mascara. If you are like someone who doesn't like, you know, have much eye issues, or you're not going to go like get wet or anywhere, then you can definitely just use like a non-waterproof mascara. But make sure if you're using a waterproof mascara, then you'll need something which is oil based to get rid of the mascara, because it doesn't come off easy. It takes a lot of time to get rid of a waterproof mascara. Again, there's various color options in this as well. There's blue mascara, pink mascara, black mascara. I have all the basic products. I really want one blue one actually. I'm thinking, let's see, maybe I will buy one. So next is lashes. Now lashes is something which changes the entire look completely. Looks really beautiful. I have very like, you know, soft lashes now, right now. So again, in lashes there are various different types. You of course use lashes with a help of lash glue. You need to use a lash glue to put on your lashes. So lash glue comes in various different types. So there's a clear lash glue, there's a white type of lash glue, and there's a black lash glue. This is basically a colors. So depends on your choice. Basically, a clear one and a black one are ideal to go with. Even there are white ones, but the white ones kind of end up becoming clear, so it, you know, looks fine. So just get, you know, putting the information out there in case you're wondering what types of lashes are, lash glues are there. For the types of lashes, so there's mink lashes, there's synthetic lashes, there's basically like foaming lashes, there are various different types of lashes. Now again, there's like soft, like looking, natural looking lashes, there are really dramatic looking lashes like this one. The ones I'm wearing are quite soft, like not maybe like really, really natural, but kind of natural, look really pretty. The ones I'm wearing are the Pack 5-3. I really like them. So again, different types of lashes. That's it. Actually, I don't have much to talk about lashes. If you want to know how to, you know, apply lashes, then I have a video for that where I teach you how to use lashes. Next one is lipsticks and lip liners. So there's various types of lipsticks. So first one is a traditional bullet lipstick. Ideal one, rotates up, looks really nice, applies like this. Next is a liquid lipstick, which is, you know, a tube. You have a liquid lipstick like this, you remove it and apply it. Is very liquidy, kind of dries down into a matte finish. Basically, these are the two types or shapes of lipsticks, and in this you again have subcategories of the finishes. So there's a matte finish, there's a glossy finish, there's a satin finish, there's a semi-matte finish. So various different types of finishes. So this one is more like a matte type of finish. Even if it's like a bullet lipstick, it's a very matte type of lipstick, right? Whereas this one is more like shiny. It's not as matte as this one. It's like that satin finish type of lipstick. So same goes with liquid lipstick. This one which I used is like that semi-matte type of lipstick, but there's really matte lipstick and then there's really glossy lipstick. I really like that demi-matte finish. I don't really like extreme matte lipstick on my lips because it gets too drying and looks really weird as well. Demi matte is like the perfect balance for any lipstick. So you can definitely add a gloss if you want. Again, the glosses, there are various types of glosses. I don't own a lot of glosses, so this is the one I have. This is from Fenty Beauty. So even in the glosses, there are different colors. So there's a shimmery gloss, there's a clear gloss, there's a colored gloss, and there's a colored shimmer gloss as well. So again, various different types of glosses in lip glosses. And in lipsticks, again, matte, shiny, semi-matte, there's even metallic lipsticks. I forgot, yeah, there's even metallic liquid lipstick, metallic lipstick, bullet lipsticks as well. Then next is the lip liner. Lip liner, there's nothing much to say. Various different colors, various different finishes. I think most of the lipstick lip liners are similar. There's not much varying types, different color options. Whichever one you want to buy, you can definitely buy one. Make sure it's at least like a two shades darker than your lips, so that just like, you know, your lips get enhanced really well. And even if you have a lipstick which is lighter than your skin tone, you can kind of play with it a lot well if you have a darker shade of lip liner. So next one is setting spray. And we're almost done. I'm so tired, my mouth is paining. So we have various finishes in that. There's matte setting spray, there's dewy setting spray. So even in dewy, there's one type which just basically just adds a dewiness, that glow to your skin. But there's one more which has shimmer particles in it. So basically it adds that shimmer, it gets that shimmer onto your face along with that. But you only use that if you are somebody who has dry skin, oily skin, it's not ideal for. So this is the setting spray I used today. This is the Faces Canada, what do you call, Ultimate Pro Makeup Fixer. Now this, the spray of this is something, the only problem I have with is the spray. Really, setting spray is all about the, you know, mist, like the spray press, because if it gives that very nice uninterrupted finish of the spray, it looks really nice, doesn't look blotchy. But whereas, you know, if it comes to this, you kind of have to spritz well, and then you have to go with a blender so that there's no blotchy patches of setting spray, and you evenly have everything. The Morphe one is like a continuous mist, so it's really nice when you press it. It gives like a very soft mist onto your face. You don't even really feel it, but this one is quite like, you know, tuck. It's like hard, not continuous. You have to play your spray, and it kind of gets in one place, doesn't get in one place. Now the last one is not a makeup item, but I just thought I'll add it here. It's basically blotting paper. Blotting paper is something a lot of people use to get rid of the shine throughout the day. It's something post makeup. You don't have to use it during the makeup process. Like 4 hours, 5 hours into the day, if you feel oily, if you have blotting paper, you can just kind of, you know, take down the oil away. It's like, if you want to be really fancy, then you can do that. Or else you can just add a brush in your purse or some puff, and you can just take that and lightly dab on your skin. Also, it will lift off the shine. It doesn't really matter, but just putting it out there that there's something called blotting paper as well, if in case you're interested. So yeah guys, that is it for this video. I'm so tired talking, we've been talking I think non-stop for 1.5 hours. But yeah, I really hope this video was useful, and I'm sorry if I missed out few points. I like tried to cover as many as possible. You can check out my other videos for other tips on how to use certain things. I've made so many videos, you can definitely check them out. I'll put a few here which I think would be useful for you. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.